gave birth to Isaiah. It's going to understand. Before that, let me go right here. Because he say, Isaiah 47 and verse 1. Come down and sit in the dust. So he's talking about Babylon the Great, man. Babylon the Great is not a Roman Catholic Church. No. Like I told you, Italy was not virgin. You know why? Because you got the children of Japheth, they were already living there, man. Okay? When you go in the book of Genesis, you can read the table of the nation, right? How the Most High, he gave to every nation the land. You go in the book of Deuteronomy chapter 32, verse 39, man. When the Most High divided unto the nation, okay? He divided unto the nation. You got to keep in mind. The Most High, he divided unto the nation the inheritance, okay? He told these people, okay, I give you this. I give this over here. Yeah, things like that, you got to understand. So, Europe was already populated. You got to keep in mind. Europe was already populated. It was already the children of Japheth. You got the children of Japheth, and you got what? Some of the scattered of our people. Some of our forefathers, the Jews, were also living over there in Europe back in those days. So we know, guess what? The Virgin Dory is talking about what? Israel, the land known as what? America today. America today. Keep in mind, all right? He said, oh, Virgin Daughter of Babylon. Let's go to the book of Psalm. Let's go in the book of Psalm. We're going to prove it. Let's go in the book of Psalm 137. Let's go in the book of Psalm chapter 137. We're going to prove it. Right? Because a lot of you out there, you see doubting. We hear a lot of people that see same way as the Roman Catholic Church. No, man. It's not the Roman Catholic Church, okay? The Roman Catholic Church is not just, it's just a piece of the whole puzzle. The puzzle of the Most High. It's just a piece, man. The Roman Catholic Church, all they do is to touch the little boy. They touch the little boy. That's what they do. They touch the little boy like we saw on the news in France. They touch over what? How many did they touch? They touch over what? 500,000. They touch over 500,000 boy, little boy in France. That just came out last week. This past week that just ended, it came out in the news that guess what? That the Roman Catholic Church, they touch over 500,000 French boy. French little boy, they touch them. That's what they do. That's the job of the Roman Catholic Church. That's what they do. I've been telling that to my mom, but she won't believe it. My mom don't believe it, man. It doesn't matter. I told my mom, man. I said, listen, man, these people, they're the devil, man. You got to lift up that thing, serve the Most High, keep the commandment. My mom, no, man. She sit down with the Catholic Church. But hey, there's not much I can do, man. There's not much I can do. Like I say, we preach the word. It's the Most High that gives the increase, right? So let's go right here. This is the book of Psalm. This is the book of Psalm, chapter 137. Right? Let's read from verses 1. And you got to understand, David, he was not there when our forefathers were taking slaves into Babylon, the ancient Babylon. Neither is David alive right here. He's in heaven with the Most High as an angel. David is as an angel right now with the Most High in heaven, right? However, was David on the earth in 1492 or in a 1500? David was not on the earth. David was not on the earth. But this prophecy was given unto who? David. So let's address it. Let's read it and we see. So we can break down Isaiah chapter 47, verses 1 through 2, right? Let's go to it. This is the book of Psalms. So this was a future prophecy. Future prophecy. Double-folded. Double-folded. Double-handed meaning prophecy. The ancient Babylon and the new Babylon. Because it's God down in it. David, he broke it down. David, he broke it down. To the spirit of the Most High, Yahweh, Hashem, Yahweh Shai. Let's go to it. By the rivers of Babylon, right? There we sat down. So you got to understand when you go on your Google page, right? You can see that above the ancient Babylon, okay, which is what today Iraq in Mesopotamia, right? And the Virgin Babylon, which is the United States of America, the Virgin Babylon, because the word virgin just means new. That has not been defined. Excuse me, Salakia. That has not been defined. No one has touched it, right? That no man has known. There has not been no bloodshed. Keep in mind, there has not been no bloodshed. There not be no evil, no, no, now. You don't understand? And that's why it's referred to as what? As what? Virgin. That means what? No man has touched it yet. It's ready to be given to marry, but no one has touched it. You don't understand? So, this lady, he said, yeah, we wept when we remember Zion. When we remember Zion. Because we got to keep in mind, a lot of our people, they're trying to save Babylon the Great. You cannot do it, man. That means you won't make it to the kingdom, right? Whatsoever we're doing today on this earth is all temporary. It's all vain. You got to keep in mind. Wherever you're building your mansion in El Salvador, you're building your house in Benin, Nigeria, Ghana, guess what? It's temporary, man. It's temporary because guess what? We got to be concerned about the land of our forefather, about our mother. Yerushalayim, we got to be concerned. If your concern is not about how to return to Jerusalem, that means you're seeing in the darkness, man. If your priority, you so-called blacks, Latino and Native, if your priority is not to keep the commandment so that we can return to our land, to the land that was given, promised to our forefather, Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, brother and sister, you are still in the darkness. Because a lot of you, you're trying to set up like biggest businesses. You don't want to leave Babylon. You want to be here forever. Listen, you can't make it to the kingdom. Such spirit, the Most High is not with it. Because there's